Hello dear viewers, my name is Eimantas and this is Marius. Today Marius is pilot flying and I'll be pilot monitoring. We're approaching to Antalya, runway 36 Central. We're gonna do a DME, VOR DME approach. Standard arrival, bronze 1 Romeo. So let's see how it goes. Okay, we have excessive engine vibration, engine number 2, okay. And too high EGD of engine number 2.
A bit carriage, high engine vibrations.
High engine vibrations, let's see. High engine vibration, 7.24.
Hard log green.
Okay, choose one, in icing conditions or not icing conditions. So total air temperature is 11, so not icing conditions. Go to step 6, out of throttle. If engaged, disengage.
Okay, disengaging.
Disengaged. Thrust lever, affected engine, confirm retard. Engine number 2, confirm.
Yeah.
Retard. Okay, high engine vibration checklist complete.
Vibrations below 4 units. So
yes, it's below. And bar lock is green.
Check. Now some radar trim.
I'll give you the arrival chart.
Okay. We will start following the arc at 12 miles.
Engine number 2 failure.
Okay, read garage, engine severe damage, no N2.
Okay, engine severe damage.
Okay.
Let's see.
Now we continue turning to the right.
Okay, engine fire or engine severe damage or separation. Auto throttle, if engaged, disengage. Checked. Thrust lever, affected engine, confirmed closed. It's closed.
Okay.
Engine start lever, affected engine, confirmed cut off.
Confirm.
Engine number 2, confirm. Engine fire switch, confirm pull, affected engine, confirm.
Confirm.
Number 2. Okay. So now choose one. High airframe vibration occurs and continues after engine is shut down. So it's not. So go to step 7. Isolation valve switch close. Back switch affected side off. APU bleed, air switch off.
Off.
Choose one. APU is available for start.
Okay, so already press
start. Okay. Balance fuel as needed.
Okay.
No leak. Cross speed open. Transponder mode selector TA set. An isolation valve switch after the fire has been extinguished. Auto.
Okay. So now that's fire good. You make it.
So you should put it auto, yeah?
APU is available now.
Okay, APU is available. So plan to land at the nearest suitable airport. Go to one engine in operative landing checklist on page 7.26.
APU is available, so it's on bus.
Okay. Plan a flaps 15 landing, set VREF 15.
Okay.
Maintain VREF 15 plus wind additive.
Set VREF 15.
On final approach. Okay. VRF 15 will be 140 plus 5, 145.
Okay, so your controls now.
My controls.
140, 145. Speed break 3, okay. And, okay, my controls now.
Your controls. So decent checklist, pressurization, cabin altitude, checked landing altitude will be auto, recall, yeah, checked landing data VRF 15 and will be 145 minimums. 640, yeah?
Yes.
Approaching briefing complete.
Okay. Now course 192. Okay, we send now to 1700. I'm already a bit too late now.
We can extend our approach pattern.
Okay, so I will now turn right a bit then.
Okay. Today our QNH is 1010, so it's set.
Set, yeah.
Set, both altimeters. And
okay, the
I'll turn off the door.
QNH is complete.
Yeah, just flap inhibitor.
Okay.
It's completed down to the landing checklist.
Okay.
Check, flaps 5.
Speed 180.
Okay. 15.
8150. Start descent from 6.5.
Before landing procedures, operating engine start switch continues. Cabin crew, take your seats.
And landing checklist from carriage.
Okay. Engine start switch, operating engine continues. Landing gear down, 3 green. Flaps 15, green light. Landing checklist complete.
Check.
Stabilized.
Approach the pilot.
Approach. 500, approaching minimums.
Check.
Minimums.
Landing.
Speed brake up, reverser unlocked. Sixty knots.
Up on the runway.
So guys, we managed to land even with one engine operating.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching. See you next time.